Hi friends, welcome to Delicacies on the Plate. Today I am going to make egg biryani, another delicious biryani dish. Turns out to be super tasty and it's very easy. If you like this recipe, do give a thumbs up, share it with your friends and subscribe for more such delicious recipes on Delicacies on the Plate. To make egg biryani, first I am going to prepare the rice, for which I have taken water in a huge saucepan. In this, I have added the salt to taste, a piece of mace, 2 bay leaves, then goes in 5 to 6 cloves, 3 to 4 sticks of cinnamon, 1 black cardamom, 3 green cardamom, which I have just roughly crushed it. All these whole spices will give a nice flavor to the rice. Then herein I have around 300 grams of soaked rice. This is basmati rice which I have soaked for last 30 minutes. I'll add it into the water and cook till it is 85 to 90% cooked. Preferably use basmati rice to make any biryani dish. See to it that all the grains are well separated after it is done. Give it a light stir and then let it get cooked. I've kept the flame on a low to medium heat. You can see here all the grains are well separated and it is almost done. Lastly, I'll add around a tablespoon of oil so that the rice doesn't stick to each other. Give it a stir and then I'm going to strain out the rice from the water and wash it with cold water so that all the starch from the rice gets separated. You can see here the rice is done. So now I'm going to strain it. Switch off the flame. If you want, you can also add in half bowl of water so that the cooking process of the rice stops. And so you can easily just strain out the rice and remove it in a plate. Proceeding further, herein I have taken a saucepan. So in the next step, I am going to add in good amount of oil into the pan. I have taken around 4 medium size of onion. I am going to fry them till they turn golden brown in color. I have sliced them in thin strips. So herein, I am going to add all the onion strips into the oil. Keep the flame on a low to medium heat. Don't fry it on a high heat, otherwise it can get burnt and it will not get evenly fried. So meanwhile, I'm going to marinate the eggs, the boiled eggs. First, I'm going to poke it with the knife so that while frying it doesn't splutter. And I have taken half teaspoon of turmeric powder, 1 teaspoon of Kashmiri red chili powder, and I'm going to just simply coat this eggs with the spices. It should get nicely coated. So herein the egg is also ready. Now herein the egg is also ready. After the onions are fried, I'm going to fry these eggs too. You can see here, in between give it a stir so that the onion is evenly fried. Now I'm going to prepare a paste of 1.5 inch of ginger and 15 to 20 garlic cloves. Add a bit of water so that it turns out into a smooth paste. Now you can see here, these onions are also fried. I am going to remove it from the oil and proceed to the next step where I will be frying the eggs. So herein in the same pan, I am going to cover all the sequins and layer the biryani. So in the leftover oil, add in the eggs. Keep the flame on a low to medium heat. Cover it and fry till each egg gets a nice golden brown covering on it. So after a few minutes, you will see here all the eggs are nicely fried. Remove it from the pan into a plate. Remove all the eggs one by one and then proceed to the next step wherein I'll be making the masala. So in the leftover oil, I'm going to add in some whole spices. So goes in 1 teaspoon of Shah Jeera, let the jeera change its color, and then goes into bay leaves, 2 to 3 cinnamon sticks, 5 to 6 cloves, 1 small piece of mace, 1 small piece of star anise. I have 3 to 4 pieces of blackstone flour. This is a very important ingredient while making any non-veg dish. Then I have Kashmiri red chili, whole I have taken, which I have cut into small pieces and added. Add in 3 to 4 green chilies, chop it and add it to the oil. Chilies you can add as per your preference, how spicy you want it. Saute for around a minute. Keep the flame on a low to medium heat. To this I'm going to add in little bit of fried onion. So I have divided the fried onion in 3 parts. 1 part I have added over here into the oil. Saute for about 30 seconds. It's already fried, so no need to cook for more time. Then goes in the ginger garlic paste. Cook this till the oil starts to separate. Mix it well. And then goes in some dry spices. Goes in 1 teaspoon of garam masala, 1/2 teaspoon of turmeric powder, 1 1/2 teaspoon of Kashmiri red chili powder to give a nice color to the masala. Then goes in 1/4 teaspoon of cumin seeds powder and 3/4 teaspoon of coriander seeds powder. Saute the spices for about 30 seconds along with the masala. Now herein, I'm not using curd. I'm going to show you this recipe by using tomato. I have made a puree of 4 medium size of tomato. Add it to the saucepan and mix it well. If you're using curd, add 1 medium bowl of curd. After adding the curd, stir it vigorously so that no lumps are formed. And after I use this tomato, the taste is as good as the curd. So you can also use in tomato to make this egg biryani. I'm going to cook this till the oil starts to separate from the masala. Goes in salt to taste, and then goes in 1 small bowl of finely chopped coriander leaves and 1 small bowl of finely chopped mint leaves. Mint leaves is a very important ingredient when you're making biryani, so don't forget to add that into the masala. Mix it well. I missed out the green cardamom and black cardamom. This has to be added into the oil, so it's fine, I have added here, but you do not miss out to add it into the oil. Now to this I'm going to add in a tablespoon of dry fenugreek leaves. This also enhances the flavor of the masala. Give it a nice mix. After 3 to 4 minutes you will see here the oil has started to separate from the masala. I have kept the flame on a low to medium heat. Give regular stirs so that the masala doesn't get burnt. Now herein I have added the eggs. Mix it well so that the eggs are nicely coated with the masala. And then I am going to remove this back into the plate, after which I am going to layer the biryani. So herein I have removed the egg and the masala into the plate. Now while layering, first goes in the egg along with the masala. Spread it all across the pan evenly. Above this I am going to add in the rice. So divide the rice into 2 parts and make a uniform layer of the rice above the egg. Spread it all across into the pan. You can see here the rice, all the grains are well separated, and so nicely it is cooked and it is looking very attractive. Then goes in the fried onions. Spread it all across the rice. Then goes in some finely chopped coriander leaves and mint leaves. And above this I am going to add in the egg and the masala. So in this way I am going to layer the biryani. And I am going to repeat the process with the leftover rice and coriander leaves and onions and mint leaves and eggs and masala. Spread it all across the rice to make a uniform layer. So now goes in the leftover rice. Above this I am going to spread the fried onions. You can see here, it is looking so tempting, this biryani, and it is going to turn out to be as delicious. Then goes in the finely chopped coriander leaves, then the mint leaves and the leftover egg along with the masala. Now here in the layering is done. Now I am going to add in some essence and food color. So first goes in some saffron strands which I had soaked in 2 tablespoons of warm milk. Add it on one part of the rice. Then goes in 1 teaspoon of rose essence. Herein I have rose essence. I'll take 1 teaspoon of it. Spread it all across the rice. Then goes in 1 teaspoon of kevra essence. All these essence makes the biryani so flavorful, and also the aroma out of it is very tempting. Then finally goes in 1 teaspoon of yellow food color. I'm going to add it on the other part of the rice. So this will make the biryani more colorful. Now I'm going to cover it and let it cook for 10 minutes. Herein the cover what I am using is quite heavy. If yours is not, use a cloth. Cover the pan and then put the lid. So after the biryani is done, I am going to remove the lid after 5 minutes so that the steam subsides, and also it will help the rice to get completely cooked and get all the aroma from the masala of the egg. After it is done, just dig in with the spatula and remove it in a plate. You can see here it is looking so tempting and colorful. You serve this with salad or raita and papad. So delicious egg biryani is ready to serve. If you have liked this video, do like and share and subscribe for more such delicious recipes and delicacies on the plate. Don't forget to click on the bell button to get the further notifications of my upcoming videos.